this morning. Busy day of sport, as you were hearing. Mike and I will empathise and relate to this next story because this is part of our childhoods growing up. For years, Morecambe and Wise, a much-loved part of everyone's festive viewing, but some of their shows haven't been seen since they were first aired in the 1960s. It was thought that they'd been lost forever, but two recently unearthed episodes will return to our screens tonight after being hidden in a derelict cinema in Sierra Leone, of all places, for decades. Have a look at this.
Gentlemen, and welcome to the show. We have some very interesting guest stars for you tonight. We've got Ronnie Carroll and we've got Kenny. Wait a minute.
What is it?
Hairs on your nose.
Do you know that? What's this, a new gimmick or something?
It's not a new gimmick at all.
You're at it again, aren't you?
It's a living.
It's toy time, folks.
Toy time, folks.
I don't know. What is it?
It's obvious what it is.
What?
Instant camera.
Instant camera?
I've just said that. Instant camera.
Do you mean like instant potatoes and instant coffee?
Pardon?
Well, you get some camera powder and you put it in a cup and you pour boiling water on it and you get a real camera, instant camera. Is that what you mean?
How are they doing that? That's clever. Doesn't it come out, though, the same shape as the cup?
I don't know.
Or whatever receptacle you happen to put it into.
There we go. That brings back a few memories, doesn't it? Lots more of that tonight over on BBC Two. We're joined now by the man behind the tapes. He's the guy who found them, TV archaeologist Philip Morris. Nice to see you. Thanks ever
Morning,
so much
Roger.
For coming
Happy
in.
Happy Christmas.
Yeah, same to you. gosh, I mean, this is a treasure trove of stuff you've found over the years.
It certainly is.
Tell us the story of finding these two Morecambe and Wise tapes.
I've been on the lookout for Morecambe and Wise for many years. I found one episode in Nigeria in, I think it was around about 2011, and it was really badly damaged, which I was pretty heartbroken about because their first series for the BBC, which is their first colour series, was totally missing.
Right.
So I had that on my radar, and if I want to find something, I really get kind of a seven-year itch for it, and I need to find it, so...
So how do you... I've looked through the list. I mean, you found all sorts of things. Old episodes of Doctor Who, old episodes of Morecambe and Wise, lots more besides. Often in Africa.
Yes.
Why in different countries, Nigeria, Sierra Leone, why in Africa?
Well, they were all British colonies in the 1960s. Independence had just been given to some of them. So these things from the former BBC enterprises were basically sold all over the world. They went global, really. Mm. And... it's my job to track whatever's still out there down, which I really enjoy doing. I think I've got the best job of it going, really.
I think you've got a great job. So let's say you decide you're going to find a couple of some Morecambe and Wise.
Yeah.
How do you end up in a derelict cinema in Sierra Leone?
This was by chance, actually, because I'd visited Sierra Leone around about 2011, 2012 to visit their television station. Now, sadly, it had been destroyed in a civil war. And I thought, well, that's it. And I got to know the hotelier there really well because I spent a few extra days there. We went fishing, had a couple of bottles of vino. And he said to me, you'll have to come back. And it was earlier this year. He said, well, when are you coming back? I said, well, I'm really busy. I was in the Middle East at the time. He said, well, did you ever visit the cinema? I said, why would I go to visit the cinema? He goes, well, they used to borrow programs from the television station. I said, really? I said, well, find out some more information and come back to me, and I'd be really interested. And he did, about a week later. He said, well, the cinema's been closed for many years, but there could be something there. So I got my visa, got on the plane, got my hat on, and I headed out there, and lo and behold, in this old building, as I was going through some old film cans, there were two episodes of Morecambe and Wise, series one. It was one of those punch-the-air moments. You know, it's really, for me, I'm a huge Morecambe and Wise fan. It's probably the greatest double act this country's ever produced. And to find that first series was just magical. Magical.
Let's have a look at some of the stuff from tonight.
Sure she will.
Oh, my leg! Oh, my leg! My leg's gone!
Now, don't panic, anybody. It can't be very far.
I think I've broken your leg.
Broken it?
Yes, I've broken it. You'll have to just manage without me.
Yes, I'm sure we'll be able to. It was the other one a minute ago.
I mean, it's still ageless humour, isn't it?
It's fabulous.
Having said that, you know, some of the stuff that was politically acceptable is now politically incorrect in the modern day.
I have read that, and I've actually watched the scene in question.
Yeah.
And it's, if you, you've got to watch it and see it in the context that it's shown.
Yeah.
And it isn't politically incorrect. I don't think that's fair. Please watch it and make a judgment, but yeah. I don't think it is. It's funny.
So what are you looking for now?
Oh, I don't know. Hancock.
Right. Hancock's half hour.
Hancock's half hour. The list is endless, and you know the search goes on. But hopefully there'll be some nice surprises in the new year.
I'm not asking you to give away trade secrets, but where does 2019 take you? Have you got trips planned?
We have trips planned already. Yeah, there's many, many places to visit. I hope. At some point to have some more Morecambe and Wise. You know, these two episodes are fantastic, and if you're a Morecambe and Wise fan and you're going to see these tonight, you're in for a massive treat. If you're going to watch any Morecambe and Wise over Christmas, tune into BBC2 tonight because these are a treat. Fantastic.
It's brilliant. Thanks ever so much. And as you mentioned, Philip, it's on BBC2 tonight, is it? I don't know the time. I should know the time.
I think it's 7:50 on BBC2 tonight, am I right?
7:50 to 8:30 on BBC2 tonight. Important to send people in the right direction at the right time because it really is a treat. And the numbers of people that used to watch that, it's like, you know, 20 million or more. We'd all sit down to watch it.
We did, yeah. It was fantastic.
Thanks so much for coming in. Really grateful
to you.
My
pleasure. Thanks, Roger.
Philip Morris, who's in charge of Television International Enterprises Archives and has the best job in the world, he says. Someone else, I think, who's quite fond of their job. You must be, Carol. You're up on Boxing Day. You were up on Christmas Day. It's great to see you. How's the weather looking?
Thanks, Roger. Yes, I love my job. Good morning. The weather, well, over the next few days, it's going to be...
Our very own Sunshine Boys, Morecambe and Wise. Quite simply, one of the best-loved comedy double acts in the history of television. Between 1968 and their final BBC show in 1977, the boys recorded 71 shows. And their final Christmas show brought in an audience of over 21 million. Positive thinking helps you on the way, my friend. When things look black, try positive. I was lucky enough to have appeared with Morecambe and Wise a couple of times. I was one of those acrobatic sailors in that last Christmas show. But long before that, I popped up in the very first BBC series in 1968. Most of those programmes are stored here at the BBC Archive in West London. Positive thinking, we'll get together and... You'll notice I said that most of those shows are stored here. Well, unfortunately, the very first series that Eric and Ernie made for the BBC was lost. Actually, the corporation wiped the tapes and then reused them to make other programmes.
But by some miracle, two of those comedy spectaculars from the lost 1968 series survived and have been rediscovered. The man who found them is television archivist Philip Morris. He's a sort of Indiana Jones, travelling the world, tracking down the nation's lost TV heritage. 5 years ago, he found 9 lost episodes of Doctor Who. This year, he discovered some real comedy gems, episodes of Harry Worth, The Rag Trade, and Citizen James.
Hi, Michael.
Hello, Philip.
You're doing great work. One of the latest discoveries includes my first appearance with Morecambe and Wise 50 years ago.
So this is one of our old programmes.
And Philip has brought along the only surviving film copy.
As I recall, we did it on videotape. This is film.
That's correct, Michael. Basically, BBC Enterprises, which was the commercial arm of the BBC, made film recordings of these original videotapes, and they were sent around the world for broadcast by overseas TV stations, and that is luckily how we have these today.
Can we go and see it?
Oh, we can. Come on, let's go.
Philip, where did you find this?
This particular film was found in Sierra Leone.
Sierra Leone?
West Africa, of course.
How did it get there?
These particular films were sent out as what we call audition prints by BBC Enterprises. As kind of a taster, if you wanted to purchase a full series, they would send one or two prints out of that programme as an example for a purchase of a full series. Although you're seeing it now in its raw form, with the technology that we have today, at the end of this, the restored version, I think you're going to be very pleased to see.
So what drives you to do all this kind of thing?
It's national heritage. It's something like Morecambe and Wise. I mean, they're an institution. This is just a complete pleasure for me. You know, I just don't see how I could not.
Is there a lot more out there?
That's something I can't give a definitive answer to, for the simple reason that no paperwork exists. But I believe that there is, yes. And I'm still looking, still searching. So we could be sitting here next year. Right, you'll like this, Michael. Here comes your bit.
I think so. It strikes me, and it struck me at the time, that if you're a kind of straight guest, you don't try and be funny in right. the company of pros. But there was a little walk-off I did earlier in the show, and I actually sort of just ad-libbed that, and I thought afterwards, Eric's going to come up and grab me by the lapels and say, Sunshine, you don't do that. But they never said a word. They were very kind to their guests. It was the most marvellous experience.
You can't move now. He's paralysed, aren't you?
Well, Philip, all I can say is thank you very much for all you're doing. You're bringing sunshine back into a lot of people's lives.
Michael, thank you. It's such a pleasure to bring it back into yours too, for sharing this with me. I'm truly humbled. Thank you.
And now, for the first time in half a century, renewed and in colour, The Morecambe and Wise Show, also starring me.